Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Welcome back to Dr. Teeth. Today we are going to learn about a very important topic, especially when it has been declared an epidemic in many states of India. So today in this video, we are going to learn about all important things about mucormycosis. Why does it happen? To whom does it happen? And how we can prevent it with proper knowledge. So let's get started with today's video. And if you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing. And also let me know your feedback in the comment section below, because it really motivates me to create more videos of this kind. Now, mucormycosis, it is also called as zygomycosis. And as we know, it is a fungal infection. It is an opportunistic and angioinvasive fungal infection. So opportunistic means it does not really happen in healthy individuals. It happens in people who are immunocompromised, whose immunity is weak. And angioinvasive means it can invade the blood vessels, thereby causing necrosis and embolism. So it is common in patients with decreased body resistance. And this disease, though it is rare now, it is seen in many COVID-19 patients because they have decreased body resistance. Their immunity is quite weak, especially because of the steroids that they need to take. So the spores of this fungus, it is present in soil, it is also present in air. So it is very important that we keep all precautions so that it does not happen to us or our loved ones who have recently recovered from COVID. Let us see the types of mucormycosis. First one is the superficial, means it will remain on the surface, like the external ear, fingernails, and skin. Second type is the visceral form. It affects the lungs, that is pulmonary. We have the gastrointestinal one. And we have the rhinocerebral or rhinomaxillary form. So this form is very common in the COVID-19 patients. So there is increased incidence of rhinoorbitocerebral mucormycosis in COVID patients. But why? There are various reasons for it. First, if the patient has uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, if the patient is on steroid therapy which causes immunosuppression, prolonged ICU stay, comorbidities. Let us see the symptoms of mucormycosis, that which is common in the COVID-19 patients. The patient can have nasal blockage or congestion, nasal discharge, which can be blackish or bloody, and also local pain on the cheekbone, whichever side is affected. Then we will have blackish discoloration over the bridge of the nose and also the palate. Then one side facial pain, numbness and swelling, worsening of the headache, then eyelid, periocular or facial edema, swelling here in this region, eye region. Then in the same region, there can be discoloration. The patient can have blurred or double vision with pain, fever, and also skin lesion. Then there could be sudden ptosis. Ptosis means drooping of the eyelid. One eyelid will be closed like this. Then proptosis. The eyeball will seem to bulge out. That is proptosis. We also have symptoms that will be seen in the mouth. That is toothache, loosening of the teeth, jaw involvement, thrombosis and necrosis. Thrombosis means there will be clotting of blood in that area. And necrosis means cell death. That entire area will die. That is why we need to go for surgical removal of that part. And there are reports that patients have even lost their eye because of this. So any of these symptoms should not be taken for granted. And we need to take action quickly by approaching our doctor. We will also have respiratory symptoms. Obviously, fever and all will also be there. Now, how can we prevent it? Use mask. We have been advised to use masks since the very beginning. And still, it is very important that we always wear mask. Because the spores, they are not only present in the soil, in the decaying areas, but also present in the environment. So we have to use masks not just for COVID prevention but also for the prevention of mucormycosis. Then maintain proper personal hygiene. Control your sugar levels. Use steroids judiciously. Take them at correct time, correct dose, and also duration. Don't prolong it unnecessarily without the consultation of your doctor. Use clean sterile water for humidifiers during oxygen therapy. Always use clean sterile water. Betadine mouth gargle should be done twice a day. Now, what not to do? Don't take symptoms lightly. Do not hesitate to seek investigations if you have any of the symptoms so that the fungus can be detected. Don't delay its treatment. Very important. Now, how it is treated? Antifungal drugs like amphotericin B can be prescribed by a doctor. Make sure you always consult your doctor and take medications. And that area, that necrotic area, affected area will be surgically debrided. God forbid, I hope nothing of this happens to you or your family. And I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, please let me know in the comment section below. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I will see you in the next video. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Oh.